minute.
So what's happening is there were a lot of dramatic goals during the late stages of matches, which really boosted the excitement in Russia. But you talked about some of the surprise teams, Iceland making its debut at the World Cup. We had Russia, the host nation, making a surprising run to the quarterfinals. I didn't think they would get out of the group stage, Joel.
No, nobody did. I don't think the Russians did. They did very well. But this is what happens throughout the tournament. It started very exciting. I mean, we just have to remember the game Spain-Portugal. I mean, there was two of the same match that had this opening game after the second or third day of the tournament, and they drew 3-3.
This was high-level scoring. And later on, maybe we can talk about the scoring and why. But yeah, it was indeed. Russia was a big surprise. And Croatia, in a way, I mean, they were one of the team, but I think they were also a big surprise to get to where they were.
Now, I'd like to turn to Caroline for your take on the high-low moments. How did it compare to the few games or tournaments that you've seen before?
It seems like the 2018 World Cup really found the perfect balance and a delicate formula of excitement. It wasn't too overwhelming, but it wasn't too underwhelming. Sonny talked about the last-minute goals. There were four defeat-avoiding equalizer goals in the last minute as well, which really gave the games quite a mix-up and made them really fun to watch. And set-piece goals, meaning the goals resulted from free kicks or corner kicks, were a pivotal aspect of the matches, with 43% of the goals scored in the tournament coming from those setups, which is the highest ratio in any World Cup since 1966. So all of these elements really together set the 2018 World Cup apart from past tournaments and generated